This whole area is just like expat haven, expat central. Hey, good morning travelers. Today I am in District 2 of Ho Chi Minh City, Vietnam. I spent my first week in Vietnam on this trip in District 1, and honestly, I was really happy to get out of there. District 1 is just very, very touristy. Everyone on the street is just trying to sell you stuff and get you to get a massage at their place or buy something from them. Oh,
I got some dogs over here. Hey guys!
Anyway, I'm really happy that I decided to get out of District 1, check out District 2, which is not something that I've done previously on different trips, on previous trips to Vietnam. But yeah, so far I'm really enjoying District 2. I booked the cheapest hotel with a private room in District 2. So I guess one thing about District 2 is that it's really common with expats. Like, most of the expats that live in Saigon live in District 2. So we're gonna start by checking out that area because I'm a little bit south of that right now. There's like this river and I am just a little bit south of there. So let's find a driver.
Hello.
Let's find a driver and let's get over to the part of District 2 where all the expats choose to live. And then this video will just be kind of exploring District 2, seeing what it's all about, seeing how the expats live here in District 2. And at the end of the video, I'll show you guys my $13 a night hotel room, which also has like studios, like apartments that you can rent per month for like $350. So stay tuned to the end if you're curious to see what a $350 apartment in Ho Chi Minh City is like.
Motorbike, yeah, motorbike. Yeah. I go to Block. Lock? I can show you on my phone.
Lifestyle Park.
Wait for a minute.
Okay.
50,000 now.
50,000?
Yeah.
On Gojek, it is 17,000 or 13. But maybe see if he will do 25,000, I will pay him extra. Because on Gojek is 13.
On, yeah. Huh?
He knows ride Gojek.
Oh, okay. Do you want to do? So right away they wanted 50,000 for my ride, and yeah, that's like four times as much as I could get in just on the app. So I'm just using the app. 13,000 for the app. I think those guys thought they could get a lot more money out of me because I'm a foreigner, and most foreigners that come here probably are not like negotiating that much and checking the apps and confirming what the actual price is. So yeah, anyway, oh, I think this might be my driver. Thank you very much. All right, we're good. We're off. Oh, check out this tree these guys are carrying. It's beautiful. All right, guys, so we arrived here at Block, which is like a nice place to eat and get coffee and stuff like that.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, doing well.
So is this is a place to eat and get coffee?
Yes. We are the Lifestyle Retail Park.
Oh, so Lifestyle Retail Park.
So basically, we have a lot of business.
Okay.
Yeah. And the ground floor is mainly the food court.
Okay.
And in the second floor, you can find the shops and stores.
Oh, yeah. Totally.
The third one, there are the bars and the shisha place, which is really cool.
So I guess that was the events coordinator I was talking to, and she actually recommended I come back in like a half hour, an hour, because there's an event that's about to start. And she's like, it'll be so much better if you're here for the event instead of right before it. All right, guys, so while we're waiting for Block to have that event and that event to open up, let's just explore this downtown area of District 2. So the friends I met yesterday have lived in Vietnam for like 8 years. They were saying that this whole area that's yellow on the map right now is all like the downtown area that has, I'm not gonna fit through there. Back up. This whole yellow part is like where you'll see all the foreigners here in District 2. Definitely a lot of really nice cafes here in District 2. I take one coffee with milk, please. Oh, this is a really nice setup. Most of the time I'm getting coffee on the street, it's from a plastic bottle, but there's actually a machine right here. Well, that's awesome. And it's still 15K. Really good coffee. So far my impressions of District 2 is that it has a lot of stuff to accommodate foreigners, even a Starbucks right here on the main drag. You definitely don't want to live here though if you're trying to stay under $1,000 a month for your budget, because I've been looking at the menus on these places and like everything's over like 10 bucks for a meal, it looks like. So $1,000 a month budget probably is not gonna work if you're on this main strip in District 2 here.
All right guys, it's been an hour, so this event at Block here should be going on again.
Ooh yeah, it looks like it is. Let's go check it out.
All right. It's the Sweet Tooth Weekend Market. Free entrance for all. Ooh, these are looking good. Hello. Did you make these?
Yeah.
Oh, you made them.
Yeah.
What's the best one?
If you love chocolate, so this one I would mostly recommend. It's coffee dark chocolate.
Coffee dark chocolate.
Yeah.
Oh, I want one.
Okay.
Yeah, how much is one?
20.
20?
Yeah.
Okay.
You can take one of these as well.
Yeah. Oh, thank you very much. Oh, perfect. Thank you. Thank you.
Chocolate coffee cookie. It's really, really good. Okay, so I just took a grab back to my hotel. I'm gonna show you guys the rooms here and then end this video because I got really sunburnt today on all the motorbikes I was on. So that's gonna be it for today. But yeah, let me go show you these rooms.
All right, so this is the apartment, huh? All right, so we got a desk, nice big TV here, bed, place to sit. Let's see, little kitchen area, do some cooking, nice bathroom. Yeah.
Okay, so this place is 10 million dong a month. That's this in US dollars. It does not include electric. 4,000 dong per kilowatt. So that's really just gonna come down to how much you run the AC, and it's got AC in it. Stuff obviously. Yeah, this place is a pretty good deal.
This is the view. Looks like you got some construction going on out there right now. But yeah, super nice. All right, and then here are the hotel rooms that are $13 a night.
So you got a refrigerator, a TV, a little desk thing here, place to put your clothes. My room doesn't have this actually, so not every room has this. But a nice bed. I think this is like a double bed.
Two chairs, a little table. Obviously the air conditioner and a fan, which is really nice actually to have both. And then nice clean bathroom. Really, really nice.
All right guys, I'm gonna probably be in District 2 a couple more days. So if you have any recommendations of places I should see in or around District 2, let me know in the comments down below. And I will see you again very soon in another video. Peace.